In the dry, sparsely populated desert of eastern Oregon, Paisley Cave contained the earliest human DNA ever found in North America, causing experts to revise the view that Clovis people were the earliest humans on the continent 12,000 years ago. Researchers at Paisley dated human scat at 14,000 years ago and uncovered artifacts just as old. But Paisley is not the only cave in eastern Oregon to contain evidence of early Americans. A site named Cougar Mountain Cave held an astonishing collection of artifacts from ancient Americans. Cougar Mountain Cave was studied by archaeologists from Oregon State University, and the contents are housed at the Favel Museum in Klamath Falls, Oregon. Curator Pat Millian tells us more about Cougar Mountain Cave.
Cougar Mountain Cave is located up in the northeastern, lapping over into Lake County from Klamath County. That's where the location is. And the things that are in there keep getting older. I know that sounds strange, but we've had students who have been studying this cave, and they keep finding new ways technology-wise to date things. And so the exciting thing for us is that it had been early developed, that it was about 9,000 years old. Now we find that there were materials in the cave 13,500 years old. And so what there is in that exhibit is remnants of basket making, clothing, the shoes that you see, bows and arrows. And then probably the most important thing are the arrowheads that are called Western stemmed arrowheads. And that is having an interesting history as far as where they came from and how it all developed. Because they seem to think that the Western stemmed were originated here, and they went from west to east. And the old Clovis points that you hear so much about were in New Mexico and came west. And so they were much slower to get here, I guess, than anything else. And they figured that the stemmed western points are as old, if not older, than the Clovis points.
As rich as the Cougar Mountain site was, it's not the only cave to contain a treasure trove of artifacts from first Americans. Further east in Oregon, Trout Creek Cave contained a plethora of artifacts left behind by people living here thousands of years ago.
Larson Cave is an area just north of Reno, Nevada, and Pyramid Lake is still a viable lake, and across just a small hilltop, really, it would have been Lake Winnemucca. And the Larson Cave was found in some of the tufa stones in Lake Winnemucca. And that lake is no more. It's all dried up. But in that area down there, the tufa rock is a very lightweight rock, probably, you know, a volcanic type eruption thing. And the cave itself is really not a cave, I guess I would say. It is an opening in this tufa rock where they feel that the natives from the desert area came in to fish, and they stored their equipment, so they weren't carrying it back and forth. They were probably carrying dried fish. And so they just left it there, and it was there every year they came. And that's where all of those artifacts came from. The interesting thing about Nicolarson Cave is that it has, or this exhibit rather, has one of the only atlatls known that still has, is intact, basically. And the reason I say that is because the notch at the end of the atlatl spear is still wrapped with sinew, and the rock that is called a boat stone, which is about midway in the atlatl, and an added heft to the throwing of the atlatl, it was tied on also with sinew. And so it's unusual to find anything of that sort because of the rodents. They would find these things and chew them up.